through the mist by the milk light of moon. All that was lost is revealed.
Over the Garden Wall's opening scenes throw viewers into the unexplained journey of two brothers, named Wirt and Greg, through dense woods. With no context given until the very end, viewers are taken on a captivating ride through their brothers' random encounters with the inhabitants of the aptly named unknown. Though the variety of the people the brothers meet is broad, going anywhere from an axe-wielding hunter to civilized frogs and skeletons dressed as pumpkins, one thing is constant throughout the story. The brothers must avoid the beast at all costs, or they will be consumed and turned into Edelwood trees, forever stationed in the unknown. The scene I'll be analyzing today is, in my opinion, one of the strongest scenes in the entirety of the show. For context, after being split up from their bird friend and realizing their journey so far has been for nothing, Greg and Wirt wander aimlessly, and viewers witness Wirt's complete loss of faith in the brother's ability to get home. Due to his waning spirits, Wirt begins to be consumed by the beast. However, the ever-positive Greg is on his own journey in the land of the clouds, while his brother sleeps. The scene picks up right after Greg defeats a wind monster in the land of the clouds, and I'll let it play from there.
Why, hello, Gregory.
Hello.
I am the Queen of the Clouds. Thank you for saving my city.
You're welcome.
I shall grant you one wish. What do you wish for most of all?
Well, I'm supposed to be the leader, but I don't know how to get home. Do you know?
Of course. If you wish, I can certainly send you home.
Great! Let's go get Wirt.
I'm sorry, Gregory, but Wirt cannot go with you. He is too lost.
Anything is possible if you set your mind to it, right?
See how the Edelwood grows around him? The beast has claimed him already.
Oh, I should have been leading better. I was goofing off again like always, and now you're stuck here. Isn't there anything I can do?
I'm sorry, Gregory. Wirt's fate lies solely in the beast's hands now.
Then I know what to wish for.
Are you sure? Then it shall be done.
Hey, Wirt!
Shh! Trying to sleep.
Okay, you sleep. I'm sorry I got us lost, Wirt. Will you take care of Ronald for me? Okay, I have to go now. Goodbye, Wirt.
Yes, come, Gregory. There is much to be done.
And then you'll show us the way home, right?
Of course. We made a promise, didn't we?
Greg. Greg? Greg? Greg! Where did he go? No. Greg! What the heck? Greg! Greg! What did I do? Greg! Greg! Ah!
I believe this scene to be so important due to the fact that, through the use of certain devices, which I'll get to in a second, the directors and animators are able to completely change the tone of the show and really collect in on the viewer's investment in the characters and their journey. Note the light atmosphere of the Cloud City, and how the Queen is comprised of warm, saturated colors. Greg is genuinely happy to be given a wish, and rather than asked to be a tiger again like he did earlier in the show, he wishes for safe travel for him and his brother. Even when he isn't unable to be granted this, he stays true to his character by sacrificing himself for the person he loves the most. And even as he says goodbye to his seemingly hopeless brother, he remains positive. Also note the complete change of scene back into the unsaturated and cold forest, and the chilling transition of focus onto the beast as Greg moves his shoulder and heads deeper into the unknown. By using setting and shifting the mood while staying true to the characters, the showrunners completely strip viewers of any security they thought they had had between the brothers, henceforth setting the tone for the final episodes of the miniseries and keeping viewers on the edge of their literal seats. Personally, the uncertainty I felt while watching Greg whisper his wish into the Queen's ear and the gut-wrenching sadness I felt for Wirt as he escaped the Edel Woods' grasp and desperately calls out for and chases his brother are two of the reasons why I love this show, and why it inspires me to work hard on all of my videos. This show is able to use drawings and animations to completely encapsulate its viewers in the world it has created, and this inspires me to attempt this same task in the media that I produce as well.